It is that time of the year again, American Independence Day, July 4th. There are two options the way I see it. Get killed by a psycho Uncle Sam, or watch fireworks. So I chose fireworks. Last year, I went to Long Beach to see the fireworks by the Queen Mary, and it was pretty epic. This year, I wanted to top it.
And we are counting down to the Big Bay Boom. In less than a week, you will be able to see the biggest fireworks show on the West Coast right here in San Diego.
Kasha, this really is the biggest celebration of the summer. But for all the folks that are thinking about coming down here, you can't just roll in about midday and think it's going to work out. You need a plan.
Fireworks are launched from four barges in San Diego Bay. The main spots you can view the fireworks from are the North Embarcadero, the South Embarcadero, Shelter Island, Harbor Island. This is what they look like from Harbor Island, which was my second choice, and Coronado. I left shortly after 10 a.m. and arrived shortly after 11:30. There was minimal traffic until the bridge, which was testing my fear of heights. Parking was definitely suspenseful. I did have a space reserved downtown across the bridge as a backup, but I found a spot just before going back to the bridge. After parking, I had a 20-minute walk to the ferry. It was a beautiful day. You could say immaculate. The bay was busy with powerboats, sailboats, and kayaks, like these. And my cool little camera got noticed and questioned, and there was a swimmer. Then the ferry arrived, after a reasonably short wait. By the way, I had no line to buy my ticket for the ferry. Then the ferry unloaded. Then we loaded onto the ferry. And there I am. Some people were nervous about having to go to the bathroom, as there are no bathrooms on board. And some people were also concerned with seasickness. For me, it was a chill alternative to the bridge. That's the USS Midway, which I was going to visit. The USS Midway seemed like the perfect place to visit on the 4th of July, to kill some time before the fireworks. And there were some clowns on our ferry. And then it was time to get off, but not before getting some final shots of this fine vessel. The USS Midway was a truly epic museum, and it will be featured in my next video. I covered the history of the Navy in the San Diego area in my Christmas Coronado video from last year. Another interesting thing, the USS Midway was hosting its own fireworks viewing party. After soaking up this place, I walked around the downtown waterfront before catching the ferry back to Coronado. After arriving back in Coronado, I walked along the Coronado waterfront via the Bayshore Bikeway. I was headed to the Coronado Bridge viewpoint, which is in the Coronado Tidelands Park. Since my phone was losing charge and my Pocket 2 camera had completely lost charge, I had to walk back to my car to get my power bank before I could launch the drone for these epic shots. The first flight was shot at golden hour. As with my Pocket 2 camera, which caught the interest of at least three people, my drone caught the interest of a young man on a bike, and he inquired about it. A young woman also complimented my drone. Sounds like wife material to me. That cruise ship may be from Disney, Carnival, or Norwegian Cruise Lines, as all three operate out of San Diego. A few quick facts about the bridge. Maybe I will do a history video at a later date. The Coronado Bridge opened to traffic in 1969. The bridge is 11,179 feet or 2.1 miles long. It rises 200 feet above the waterline. And on a bleak note, the Coronado Bridge has had over 400 suicide jumpers and trails only the Golden Gate Bridge as the most often used bridge for suicides in the United States. Then I launched my drone at Blue Hour. This is the Coronado Municipal Golf Course. Looking at all these beautiful scenes, it is crazy to think that I was having cold feet about the trip. Dealing with the hassle of the drive and the crowds and the parking, it all had me worried. And the uncertainty about where to fly my drone and if there would be any problems. But clearly, taking off was the right choice. In the distance is the western side of the island and the famous Hotel del Coronado, which is off to the right. And they have their own fireworks show too. These people launching their boat were pretty emblematic of what San Diego and the summer is all about. There was just so much beautiful twilight atmosphere for my second walk along the Coronado waterfront. Neon lights and bikes and skateboards. It was all just so magical. There was a 4th of July dance party at the Rady Shell across the bay. That's that really bright area. This spot was my first choice to launch my drone, but the flight was disabled here. Then I used the restroom at what turned out to be an amazing restaurant that is now on my list. These are some of the highlights of what the fireworks looked like from the ground. And then I launched my drone for the last 15 minutes. This is the finale. Watch for the mirror split screen effect. it was time to think about going home. But first, I walked along the boardwalk again to Smart and Final for an energy drink, before checking out some of the ferry landing shops, which were way busier than during my Christmas visit. Soaking up all this atmosphere was a really great decompression from all the activities of the day. Another thing, the ferry had special extended hours for the 4th of July, just in case you were wondering. The moon was pretty epic too that night. Then I walked alone back to my car, but it did not spare me from the gridlock leaving Coronado. But at least I was close to the bridge, and the rest of the drive home was quite smooth. And with that, please spread the magic by hitting the thumbs up, sharing your thoughts, and possibly subscribing.